Christmas, and we don't do it by the book either, do we? But thanks for coming, I really appreciate it. It wouldn't be the same without you, feel cheaper. Just gonna divert a little bit, because some of you might know, or might not. We've had a pre-match substitution. Someone pulled up in the warm-up. My sister is not here.
Nice to do.
I don't know if you've heard about this thing called COVID, just a little bit. You know, I'm going to talk about it, but unfortunately she's now spending all the Christmas enjoying her from Groom.
She's not here.
And it's a shame, because probably all the time I'm going to say a nice sentence about her. But look at her, you know, at least she's got a nice dress for Queen's speech. So when I had a speech, I didn't know where to start, really. Ended up on my phone. But some of you know Georgia, quite embarrassing at times. She writes little poems and little rhymes. And when she does me lunches, where I don't have to put you on once every month, she puts one in my lunch bag as well. And it's quite embarrassing how I work. And she always takes a minute because I can't write a poem or a rhyme. But I thought, I'm going to set that challenge up. So I'm going to rhyme my own speech. And what I found out when I was writing it is, she was right, I'm absolutely not doing it, so I thought it was. Well, here we go. See how we go. A while ago, I joked to Georgia that I was going to do my whole speech in spoken verse. She said she couldn't think of anything worse. One hour away. But I figured if I rehearse, I could take a potential curse and make it to a blessing. I'm not messing around, I'm just going to rhyme this entire time. I don't know the usual way to do it, but I've got a mic and I don't give a shh. No less. Some thank yous, so bridesmaids. Let's make a start with our team bride. Three incredible girls stood by Georgia's side. You've all played an important role at various stages through your life, creating memories of and support to the woman I've got to call my life. This is Ivan, I thought. Ashley, you got here. Ashley, our sister's girl, I guess you're okay. Sorry I've got all the good DNA, by the way. But hey, don't feel ashamed. Mum and Dad love you. Nearly the same. Seriously though, you've been a top sister. Now you've got a little image and a decent mister. Until I test it positive. You won't be long until your wife stood up here in the night talking shy. Katie, how are you? You really are one of a kind. The university is where your paths aligned. You've always been there to make Georgia smile. And as far as me, it's got your best friend of mine. From messing nights out with trips to the zoo, even when Nathan calls a giraffe a kangaroo. That's a private joke, you probably won't. There's one thing that we'd really like to say. Despite the fact you're 100 miles away, you might be bonkers, strange and insane, but as part of our family, you'll always remain. Have you ever tried to rhyme something about banter, by the way? Another thing Jack told me, which is quite apt with shit banter, but... Attic, where do we begin? Someone do us a favour and keep off the gin. There's been so many memories, it's hard to pick the best. We've watched you go into a beautiful woman from an annoying little pest. Our girls really adore you, that's for sure. Along with the amazing living room, we found these six and four. Atty, I guess we just want to say thanks for playing a special part in our wedding day. These three girls are really world class, so please join me and raise your glass to our team bride. Parents. Not only have you given us a wedding day to remember forever, you are shining examples of how to live our lives together. Kelly and Mark, what can I say? You put with me like on the first day. Kelly, I've never met a bigger board game sheet. Mark, you're worse than a woman than you know if you clean and mean. When it comes to parenting, John has picked up the mantle, and all of the remaining traits have come from your guys' example. So thank you for welcoming me to the family club. I'll strive to be the best husband, father, and son-in-law that I possibly can. Big shout out to my mum and dad. I know when I was younger, I was like the devil's spawn. You looked after me from the day that I was born. You never punished me badly as a team when I sneaked in plastered. And of course you put me in the place where I was a cheap little bat. I wouldn't even know what to say to describe what you've done for me. Until today. Your loyalty knows no bounds, especially when you count in the pounds. You You've supported me in everything I want to do. The list is endless, I'm sure, almost a few, but there's rugby, drama, football, music to start, followed by jigsaw, splatting batteries, and building me a whole car. That's strange, child. However, I can only achieve the things I have because I've had security, and that's because you guys never gave up on me. And when I think about that, I realise how big being a parent will always be. I'll tell you what I implement and what I've learned from you, so my two little girls can go into absolute legends too. So now can we all pause, stop and take a pause, to raise a glass for my parents and in-laws. Hello, girls. Oh, you were there.
Mr. Williams,
Jake, you've got the room. On to a special mention, we're all two my Billy with one box and aim of the red curls. Couldn't hide the smile as you both walked down the aisle. But now I want you to listen carefully, as a few things you should know. Once I'm done, you can carry on, causing mischief on the dance floor. To start, I want to make it known that I'll always have your back and you'll never be alone. No matter what you both do, even when Billy tells everyone she needs a poo. I'll be bursting with pride and stood by your side, that's for sure, because my love for you is unconditional and innocent and pure. So here's to Ava and Billy, our beautiful flower girls. Best man. Hey. There was never any doubt who my best man would be. We've got so many memories that mean so much to me. It's been one hell of a journey, that is for sure. There's been a war, celebrations and nights out galore. We've laughed, shouted and got stressed beyond any doubt. That's all before the back nine when the golf club come out. Today's another chapter in the book of Dylan and Dale. And I can only foresee one reason this friendship will fail. That's if you put a company back and anyone visiting the local buddy bar. Calling her out, so on Compton Street, if anyone's interested. Business partner, godfather, best mate now, best man. It's safe to say you're a firm part of our family fun. There's not much else. There's really not much else to say, but in fact, you're standing by my side on our special day. Please raise your glasses to Dylan, my best man. That's most people mentioned, but there's still a lot more to go. So if you all agree, it's probably time I talked about the star of the show. Enough of that. You should all know by now, but it's a beautiful girl in white. Don't be fooled, after a few gins, you'll be put the dance floor tonight. Her beauty is clear to behold for anyone that has seen her. I say to say the rest of my life, I know the grass will never be greener. I'm sorry for these next verses may seem sloppy and gushy, but it's my aim for the next 5 minutes to ensure my bride is gushy. So in early 2009, I thought I was picking up the school. Then this girl came in and turned me into a nervous fool. I had her on MSF for some light conversation. Little did I know, she was responsible for my life transformation. She had me put in the hard yards, constantly chasing. But I knew she was worth it, she kept sending my heart racing. I put up the courage, I tried to play it cool, giving her all my best lines while I was the best rugby player in school. Like some sort of miracle, she responded really well. My persistence was paying off, my chat was working at the time. Looking around the room, I thought this girl got everything she wants, hence my surprise of getting such a positive response. Things were going great, I knew I was punching well above my weight, but now it's signed and sealed, have you guys too late? Fast forward to 2016, 7 years she's put up with me. I knew I had another option. That makes it sound like I didn't want to do it, I did. I knew I had another option but to get down on Monday. With baby Ava at my disposal, I grew a set of balls and delivered a marriage proposal. But we all know Christmas is George's favourite time, so the speech would be complete if he didn't mention it in the rhyme. I think I ought to apologise in advance. You haven't been smoking anything, I don't think, and you're not in a trance. But sit back, relax, and have a bowl. As the fairy tale chatter, I will now recall.
I got down on one knee,
I asked, will you marry me? days away and dreamed of takeaway. But I'm a lucky one. Look at the girl I've won. I've got a feeling our family are so proud, so happy with me. I love you, Georgia. See a future where all our dreams come true. Here we go. Gorgeous. She's a kind of cookie and including a mole. But I let me tell you, she don't have snow. When you burst up my hand and that pulse will play. Before me, I knew what was in store. Every day, as we dance and celebrate our wedding day.